Triceratops! Remember, the real winner of the Power Rangers movie was Krispy Kreme donuts. I cannot tell you how much I really wanted a donut after watching this. Watching the Power Ranger movie, and oh my god, it was awesome. I'm not gonna say it's one of the best movies ever seen, but I enjoyed every bit of this. There were certain points here and there that I was a bit bored and I was hoping the story would progress, but that was more in the middle portion when they're trying to acclimate to their powers. Even though I put in the title of this video that there's gonna be spoilers, I'm saying it one more time just in case you weren't aware of it, so you've been warned. First up, at the very beginning, when we see the battle between the Red Ranger and the Green Ranger, where the Green Ranger was Rita and it turned out the Red Ranger was Zordon. It reminded me of that independent Power Rangers movie made by Joseph Kahn that showed a very darker, reimagined future for the Power Rangers, which is funny because Saban disavowed this movie and didn't like it very much, but in this movie that they made, it seems as though they borrowed some of the elements from this darker future. But even though there is a lot of dark elements to this, there's also a lot of cheesy campiness involved in it too. Anyone who has watched any of the Power Rangers series knows that most of the dialogue is very cringeworthy if you're looking at it at an adult standpoint. But the story is PG-13, so we do get some elements here and there that's not quite so kidified. In the original 90s series of the Mighty Morphin Power Rangers, I related to Billy more than any of the other characters because of his nerdy, geeky side. And in this go-around, Billy is the heart of the team, and I'm so happy that they focused on him. And I know some people said they predicted about what was going to be happening with his character, but when he died, I swear to God, I really wanted to riot at that point. Luckily, though, they did bring him back with Zordon, which, by the way, Zordon was somewhat of a dick in this movie. Don't get me wrong, I am happy they changed his character up and he's not quite as noble as he was in the original series, but still, there are certain points I was thinking, damn, this guy really isn't such a good guy in this. But being that he sacrificed a power grid to bring Billy back, that did redeem him somewhat. There's three acts to this movie. The first one is them coming together and being introduced, the second one is them training to become Power Rangers, and then the third one, when they're finally able to morph and to call on their Zords. No surprise, the third act was my favorite by far. We get to see all this action and adventure, we get to see nothing but non-stop fighting, and their Zords are totally kick-ass. It was great that we were able to see the independent Zords fight on their own before they combined. In a TV series, that rarely happened. Generally, they were called on, and then they almost immediately combined into the Megazord. Originally, when I first saw the press releases of Rita Repulsa being played by Elizabeth Banks, I wasn't so happy with it, but after seeing this movie, I was wrong. She did a great job. She played a very worthy villain, although it is so obvious that she can come back for a future movie, being that she was just basically shot out into space. One thing that I was disappointed in was Goldar. I was really wanting him to have a personality. I knew from the images that were shown that it looked like he was also going to be a mindless character, but still, we got a lot of that with the putties. I feel as though this is a character that should have had some sort of personality to him. Even though the story wasn't purposely neglecting them in any way, Trini and Zach didn't really get that much screen time. I'm sure a lot of people probably already know about this, but it was made into a big hype that Trini is the first Power Ranger to come out as being gay or bisexual, which I'll accept any type of diversity that has to do with sexual orientation, but this was so minor, it didn't further on the plot at all. This was so minor, in fact, I feel like this is somewhat in the same realm as how people were getting upset about the Beauty and the Beast little bitty part about LeFou. But, you know, whatever, still, at least it is there, so future movies, Trini may possibly be in a relationship with a woman. Although I feel as though Billy should have been the gay character, as a tribute to the original Blue Ranger, which was David Yost. David is an openly gay man, and back when he was playing this character, he was made fun of behind the scenes that a lot of people didn't know about. It also prompted him to finally quit. Like all movies, there's scenes that are shown in trailers that aren't in the actual movie. There's a point where it looks like Jason and Kimberly are about to kiss, but that never happened. There's a lot of speculation as to why that scene was taken out. It's probably because of the mid-credits scene that's referencing Tommy, which I'm pretty sure is going to be a major character in the next movie, if the next movie is made. Tommy and Kimberly had a bit of a romantic thing for a bit until Kimberly left, and then Kat came in, and then Tommy moved on very quickly. This was a very fun movie. I had a great time watching it. If you're not a Power Rangers fan, you may not enjoy it as much, but I still feel as though it would be very entertaining. But if you are a Power Rangers fan, I think you would enjoy it even more. The story, the characters, this new expanded universe that could possibly introduce other Power Rangers, I think overall it was great. I'll end it at that. This is my personal opinion, but I recommend everyone out there to go watch it on their own and formulate your own opinion. So, thank you guys for watching me in this video. Be sure to check out my Patreon site, my social media sites, my websites, and everything else out there. Peace, love, namaste, and I'll see you guys later. Peace. was disappointed that there was no Bulk and Skull in this movie. There was a male bully and two female bullies. Why weren't the two female bullies called Bulk and Skull? I would have been totally okay with the idea of them changing genders and becoming females.